Okay, folks, what I'm going to show you here is that we've been putting up our welded wire fence around our T-posts, and this is around the GardAnimal area you've heard me talk about. And we're just getting around to doing that. I want to hurry up and get that done before the snows get here. But in two places, I'm having to do a full splice on the wire itself here. So what I want to show you is kind of how I start that and how I make the splice on this end. Once we have this splice made, we'll go down to the far end down here. And I'll show you how my homemade stretcher. We'll do that with it come along on the tractor, and we'll just we'll pull it tight and we'll clip it off. I've also got an interesting clip tool that I'm using. I'll show you that as well. And a lot of the T-post fittings that I've used, they're I've had a lot of people interested in them. I've had a lot of friends come up and look at them and see how we utilized them. Made in Arizona, really great stuff, and I'll show you a bit on those. But let's move ahead, and I'll show you what I'm going to do here. What I'm going to do is I'm not using any kind of a mechanical splice. I'm going to bend the wire basically myself. This is the same thing that we do in construction. If we were doing anything in the ceilings, like say tying off fixtures, we have to tie basically three wraps within an inch. It's code requirement for that. And so a lot of what I've done there, I've just applied here. Oops, excuse me. And it works real well. I want to make sure you can see what I'm looking at here. Okay, so this is the piece of fence. The back portion over here has already been tensioned and is clipped off. I brought this around so I'm three posts corner and two posts out. And this is where I'm going to make my splice. So what I've decided is to, my splicing wire will be this length right here, and it's going to be from this end to here. This vertical will be my mating vertical between each fence line. So what it means is I need to cut out these two pieces, excuse me, in each section all the way down. So generally what I do is I just use a pair of lineman's pliers, which works well. So you kind of get the idea here. So this is a wrap wire. Every one of these will be a wrap wire. And I'll do the same. This is the other end. This is the fence we're mating to. So I will do the same thing. Excuse me. It's a little dry and windy out here today, so my throat gets a little scratchy. Anyway, I'm going to continue this all the way down, so I'll pause so you don't have to watch that boring, and then I'll kind of show you how I start splicing this together. And hopefully you can use this idea on your fencing. So hang around. We'll be right back once I have all this prepped. Okay, back with you. I've got everything prepped out now, so we're all set to do the first ties. Now again, this is my vertical. This is what I'm lining both my fence lines up on. So basically, all you're really going to want to do is just pull it in until you've got them put together. So you've got a couple of overlapping wires, just like so. So what I would do is start right at the top. This one can go down and over. This one is going to come across and go under. So now you've started your splice here. And what I do for me to just make it a little easier, so I'll come down a little ways farther, pull one in, fold it over, take the other one. If this one went over, this one goes under. important thing is to make your bends in real tight so that they'll come out looking just about like that. Again, here's one other vertical. Over. Here's this one. Under. So as you're bending, make your force as close to the wire as you can, not at the end. What that'll do is that'll keep your wraps really tight. Now, I'll come back later and I'll clean up these ends. Excuse me. And like I say, when I do it, I usually take one around one way and one around the other way so that I've got my orientation started and I'm not going to make a mistake and go the wrong way. So what we finished is I've done four of the top splices here for you, showing you just how to make the wraps. And as you can see, the verticals right next to each other all the way down. This will pull consistently when you put tension on it. It's not going to give it all. And this is probably stronger than the wire itself when it's welded. So this is just the first part. This is some splicing. I've had to do this in two spots along the fence, and I'm doing it again when I finish off at the gate post. And I'll probably show you how I do the gate post. It's similar, but there's a technique of tensioning and wrapping the very end so that your fence is tight. So I'll show you that. So here's kind of the beginning. The other things I want to go through with you is the homemade tensioner that I made. You don't have to buy one. If you got a couple 2x4s and you've got some rope, you can make your own, and I'll show you how I made it. We'll put some tension on this probably. We'll probably finish this tomorrow. And we'll put some tension on it. I'll show you the clips I use and the clip tool, which is real handy and real fast. Lisa and I just run through and just blow this fence up. As soon as the tension's on it, we just fly through and clip it off. It's real easy. The other thing that I wanted to show you, I'm going to hang the gates. So I've got gate hardware, and it's the similar hardware that I'm using on the corner posts. And it's basically got straight fittings and 90 degree fittings, and you can do all kinds of other things with them. They're real easy. They're made out of a company in Arizona, and I highly recommend them. My friends have been coming up and looking at it and seeing how we put this fence together with those clips. They're just too fast, and they're extremely strong. I went ahead and came in and did the wire and a turnbuckle. And once you tighten that thing down a little bit, you couldn't pull that over with a tractor. I mean, it's amazing. But I'll show you those a little later. So we got our splices made on both sides. We got one side in the back, it's all tensioned and clipped. Next step is we're gonna tension this. So I'll finish this up. We'll tension this side and we'll clip it up. So we'll show you that next. Be right back.
And I cleaned the top of the boxes too.
Okay.
So what?
All right, good morning. I'm going to give you a quick overview of what we're going to do. This is the short side front, so this will finish off to the left side of the gates. And then that's the chicken coop and run in front. This is the second long side, and I'll just kind of walk down here with you. So this is the side we're going to now pull tight with my homemade stretcher. And then we'll come back and we'll clip this one off, and I'll show you the tool and show you the clip, the clips we're using. I wanted to come back over and show you the splice. If didn't get a good look at them yesterday. So here are the splices. So you can kind of see how they ended up, and that's all the way down. So they actually turned out pretty darn good. You can have a light here just a hair. And these we'll carry the weight and they'll carry the stretch. Let's move back down here. And get in a spot where I can kind of show you the stretcher real quick. My little rope set up. And then I'll show you as we get it bolted together and we get it hitched up, how everything works. Okay, so here's my homemade stretcher. As you can see, it's nothing more than a couple of 2x4s. And it has 3 bolts through it. These are 1/2-inch bolts. And there's 3 at each point. There's also there's notches. Basically what I did was I cut 2 exactly the same length, drilled, bolted, and then I came back in with my sawzall and I cut this little slot out. Cut one here and one there, and what happens is that your rope goes through here this way, through here this way to a central point. We use a clevis at that point and attach it. So what I wanted to show you was this is the fence we're going to stretch. My stretcher is in place on a straight part, so pull it out a little bit so it's straight. All the bolts are tightened down. This is pretty much set in a mid position, and my come along is up against the bucket. So what we'll do now is we'll tension up a little bit. Okay, now we'll take the tie wires that we've had holding the fence up last night. We also have, yeah, let's pop up all the wires. We had some wind here last night, so we needed to definitely wire up this fence in case something got blown against it. I think we had about 35 mile an hour wind last night, so if something were to hit this thing, it could really damage the fence. And after I did all that splice work yesterday, I don't really want to have to go back and fix everything. So it's going to hang off a little bit, just like it's doing, until I put some more tension on it. Oh. That's why it looks kind of strange down there. Is it pulled away?
This one. Looks like this one
might. Some of this extra soil here ended up when we did the trenching for the water and power to the coop. Since at this point I'm still running the coop off that solar. It seems pretty snug. Might be able to get a little bit more out of it.
I think it's pretty tight.
Yeah, I think so too. I think we can get a little more out of it. Okay, let's just make sure it doesn't hang up on these.
I'll have to.
Yeah. Did you come here to help? I came here to play. That's your job.
Well,
Are you looking down there? Okay. I think that's pretty snug.
You want to check it down there?
Yeah, it looks like it fit over that rise a little bit. I was a little concerned here about this drop. Yeah, it looks pretty good. I think we can probably clip it off.
Did you do the clip off on video yet?
No. We will. Okay, so with this I've got really good tension on it. It's nice and tight. I've got no deformation of the wire here from this, since it's bolted in nice and tight. The fence is perfect. So at this point what we'll do is we'll drop back and we're going to start clipping off the fence, and we'll kind of show you that procedure. I'll show you the tool, and then we'll relax this and go on to finish the corner. So we'll be right back. We're back, and I told you I'd show you the clip we use and the method for attaching the fence to the T-post. This is clip bender. See it right there. And this is the actual tool. And it's got this little thing that kind of flops. It's got a little tiny hole in the end of it, or in the right about here. And this is an ordinary, everyday T-post wire fence hook. So you get these in bags of 50s. So you can find this at clipbender.com. And we bought two and got one free, actually. These are pretty slick, and I'll show you how they work. So this clip has a couple things. This is your starter point. So this goes over the wire. This swings around the post, comes back over the wire, and this is the first part that you've turned down. The nice thing is this post, this tool fits right in that slot, and it's intended, and I'll show you why. So we're going to add a second wire here. And what we do is we bring it in like so. Sure you can see that. Goes over the back. We clip in this side. This side pushes out. The tool fits right in that slot. So it'll literally hang there right now. The action to do this is simply to push down and back. Drop it out. Got to back, drop it back in. And then what you want to do is give a little tug and pull it up tight. Then, this is where the little hole comes in, this little hole right here. We drop that over the back, and we put it in the hole of the hook as it's going over. The important thing is to get this thing as high up on the hook piece, as close to the wire, fence wire, as you can. It will make it tighter. So the closer you get, the more, the tighter that that twist is going to be when you pull it. And all you do is you pull it down and flatten it out. Done. It's the fastest thing I've ever seen for putting T-post clips onto a wire fence. It's well worth the investment. And you may have to play this again to see how that worked, but basically I'll run this to you real quick. So this was the part that went on the fence, like so. First thing was to, with the fence wire inside, drop this in, pull down and forward, that folds this underneath, come back in over the top and push click, and then just a little bit to cinch it up. Then this is where it comes in over the top of the fence, and I get this little hole on the end of that wire, just like that, and I snug it up as far as I can to the fence wire that's running through there, and then I simply pull this over to create the loop. So that's how easy they are. I recommend these things. I couldn't recommend them higher. I mean, they're just phenomenal. So the guy who invented these, kudos. Otherwise, you're down to fencing pliers, and this looks sharp. It's very quick, and doesn't take a lot of talent. Anybody can do these, right, babe? Uh-oh, I'm in trouble. Okay, we'll finish clipping this off, and then I want to go around and I'll show you the T-posts, the fittings I used to put them together. I've had a lot of guys asking about them. Friends of mine have come up and see how we assembled everything. It's just the fitting that connects all T-posts together, and along with some wire and turnbuckles, you can tighten everything down, and boy, it's just as solid as a rock. We'll be back and we'll take a look at that next, so stick around. Okay, so we're over with the fittings, and this is the other part I wanted to show you. If you're just going to use T-posts exclusively for your fencing, these particular fittings that I'm using on the fence are from a company called Wedgelock, Wedge-LOC. Wedgelock company, they're in Rio Rico, Arizona, and they've got a really nice brochure here, which kind of tells you all about what they do and all the different fittings and configurations that you put everything in. I have actually seen this corner post put in, and they put an ATV on the side and they hook a rope to it, and the ATV couldn't budge this. This thing is so solid. It's pretty interesting. This one right here happens to be a 60 degree brace because I have the Wedgelock gate kit right here. You can't quite see it. I'll show it to you here in a second. This is the gate kit, and on the other side I already have the gate hung. So I have the gate kit, and what this does, this comes with different fittings on it. Let me double check so I get the names of them right. This is a universal collar, and it looks just like this, and it's got little wedges and bumps on it, and it fits over the T-post like so. The other part is what they call a heavy wedge, which is this, and what happens is this will actually slide into the collar. Oop, wrong way. It will slide into the collar, and it's sliding over the top of the T-post. What this does is it locks this nut in. It can't turn, it can't pop out. It's solid. So I have that in here, and that's the base. This particular fitting is a 60 degree socket, and it's running down to another post, and I'll show you in a second, that has another 60 degree collar and a wedge. This is 60 degree brace. The other flip side of this is I've got a 90 degree collar. Now this collar runs across on the vertical and it runs to the next post, which has the same setup. It also has a 60 degree brace back. This together, and I use wire, and I'll put a turnbuckle in. And what this does is it pulls everything together. This gives you the hardware to create the frame. The wire and turnbuckle are going to tighten your frame together. Once that's done, you absolutely cannot move this. And for gates, this is really rock solid. I can't recommend these enough. If you're going to do T-posts, you need to be using the Wedgelocks. And so look them up, and I suggest them. I suggest you try them out. They're super easy. They just flip together and clip together, and they're absolutely solid. Okay, so right here, you're seeing this is the brace back to the ground. This is what supports the vertical MA gate, and you can see that's a Wedgelock collar, a wedge, and a 60 degree fitting. It's got a wire. There's my turnbuckle. And it goes straight up to the post right here. This is where it ties in. So here's the 60. Here's the 60 degree fitting. Here's a 90. Now here are those, cover those real quick. These are the gate kits. They're designed to go right on top of and work with the notches on your T-post. Go down, there's the second one. Right there. They're quick and easy. They just got a central pin, and the pin can pop in and pop out. There. They're really good. I mean, you can put some grease on them and lube them. What else? So, if you follow where this gate section is, there's my horizontal, and then this is another 60 degree brace back. And this creates a huge amount of strength for this gate and the corner of this fence. Now here's the other side. Now there's my brace back, I could cut the shorter, but I think I'm just going to cap it. I think it works well. This has got the short gate. This has got the 4-foot gate on it. The other side here will have the 6-foot gate. So the 6-foot I'm going to pin in the ground. I'll drill down, install a pipe for a sleeve, and it'll have a little gate drop in there, so it'll dog it and keep it locked. The day-to-day access will be the 4-foot gate here open. And in case I need to drive the trucks in, I can do that with the gates open. If I need a little bit more clearance, these gates, with just the pins, they just pop off and you just set the gates aside and you're done. It's really, really simple. So, again, so this is some of the fence line we've finished. It's all in, tight and clipped. This is how we finish the ends off. I'll give you a good idea. This is the other gate post. So this was my starting point. And I'll try to move in here and show you a decent shot. I need to go clean up the end of these wires. I left them a little long. But basically, all the way down is where I started. And then we worked around in a loop. And then this post will end up having the same thing. What I'll do now with the other side done, go back here, touch. What I'll do now is I'll take that clamp and stretcher bar off. I'll pull this fence over. I'll put the new stretcher on the right side of this gate, probably over in here. I'll tighten it up to this point, get enough tension on it, and then one by one I'll cut and wrap those wires individually, one at a time, probably going every third one and then going back and getting the other third. That way I can keep tension on the fence while I finish off tying the wires. And so this side will have to be tied off real snug and real tight every time as I have pressure on the fence. So we'll get to that here in just a minute, and we'll try to show you a little video of that as well, since this will be the end of the wire fence for the GardAnimal area. And chickens will have a little extra protection. So, be back in a minute. Okay, so here's the last thing I wanted to show you. We're back at the gate. This is the last stretch and the last connection to the T-post. So if you look ahead, what you've seen is I've taken the come along, and it's anchored against the other fence posts, which is fine, and goes across the opening. There's my stretcher bar, and this is what I'm doing. If you'll see, I've gone down, and in areas I've taken the verticals out, and then little by little, kind of, I'll do 2 or 3 in a spot, then I'll switch to another spot, and work back and forth until I can get down to where I'm wrapping the posts and tying them back. So there's no stress on the verticals. All the stress is on the horizontals at this point. So, you know, it's one of those things, just take your time, make it fit, wrap it real tight. And as you do, you know, you're maintaining tension. So at some point you'll cut the last one and your parts will go flying with the last bit of tension. But that's pretty much the procedure to wrapping it up, and as you can, you know, I showed you the wrap, so it's pretty much what I've been doing all along. So we'll finish this up and we'll have this part finished, and then we'll address some of the bottom and the rabbit fencing along, and I'll show you that when that gets complete. So as far as the welded wire fence on T-post, we are complete, and I'll get the gates hung here and show you that in a video later on. Thanks.